yesterday we discussed, we found that for any product, any technology that has to be popular, efficiency should be high. Okay, it has to be compact, okay, lightweight, and low cost. Low cost may be cost reduction. I don't want to discuss, but then can we try to address these issues: compact size, lightweight, and high efficiency? Okay. We said, we know that size of magnetics I can reduce by switching at a high frequency. But then every time I switch a device, okay, there's going to be turn on loss and turn off loss. Okay, so as the frequency increases, this losses also increase. Okay, so I need to control the junction temperature. Are you with me? If the junction temperature increases above the limit, the device fails. One way to use may be the heat sink and increase the cooling. Are you with me? The cooling and heat sink. But then the moment I increase the cooling requirement by using a heat sink, my size increases. Of course, there are very other force type of coolings also. My complexity increases. That is generally force cooling, the water cooling and all, they use for high power inverters. Okay. Now, one issue is, can I reduce the switching losses, turn on and turn off losses, or can I eliminate them? Eliminate, quote unquote, not strictly eliminate. Can I reduce substantially the turn on and turn off losses? Conduction losses I cannot. Voltage across the device and conduction, that has to be. So that question I need to address. How do I reduce the switching losses? The And second that I have to is, how do I reduce the size of the overall inverter? See, unfortunately, input voltage is DC. Okay, if I want to feed that power to the grid, or if I want to use it, all the equipments are rated for 230 volts, 230 line, or the phase voltage. Line is 440. If I have to feed that power to the grid, I think a crude method is, what is the crude way? I have a DC, invert it, whatever that I get, then use a suitable transformer and step it up and connect it to the grid. The moment I am saying there is a transformer, what frequency it has to handle? 50 hertz. Okay, magnetic, 50 hertz magnetic, size increases, cost increases. Are you with me? Second way is, I may have a low voltage DC, can I boost this DC voltage? I'll boost the DC voltage to a suitable value, invert it, okay, and then directly use it. Okay, to reduce the size. So there are two ways. One is boost the DC voltage. Somehow I have to eliminate that. I have to eliminate the 50 hertz transformer. Of course, unless until you want an isolation. If you want an isolation, there is no way but to use a 50 hertz transformer. Okay. Assuming that you don't want an isolation, I want to reduce the size. What do I do? Is there a better way? You will see. These are the issues. Okay. One is compact size, efficiency, and what all issues do I need to take care while connecting your inverter to the grid? Grid connection will spend substantial amount of time. So before that, today I'll just briefly finish. What are the important parameters that I have to consider while using a diode? Apart from average current rating, voltage rating, this is all fine. Which is the important parameter when I'm using a diode in high frequency application? It is the reverse recovery current. We all know that current in a diode flows from anode to cathode, but then while it is turning off, see here, this charge, whatever the trap charge, has to be recovered. So reverse recovery current is a very important parameter, okay, because that current flows from in the reverse direction, and some other device when it turns on may have to carry this current. The reverse recovery current of the diode, of course, if the for the current to flow, circuit has to be complete. So that current may have to flow through some other device. So while turning on, that current may increase its rating, or I may have to suitably design the snubber. I will if not today, maybe in those 20 lectures in the month of December, we will address this issue, how exactly to calculate the current rating and how to address this reverse recovery current heat sink calculation. Okay, so very important parameter. This is a very important parameter in high frequency diodes, high frequency reverse recovery current, especially 50 hertz AC to DC, 50 hertz, these are non issues. Unfortunately, as the frequency of operation increases, that frequency increases, this reverse recovery current also increases. Okay, so it's a very important parameter, and this is reverse recovery current and this is reverse recovery time. Okay, and the initial surge current, how do I suppose, assume that, see, we do not assume that I have configured this circuit, I have connected a diode, can I go and arbitrarily close the switch? Why, gentlemen? A simple circuit, diode, capacitor, circuit is complete. Can I arbitrarily close the circuit? What may happen? Now feel free, it's a dialogue. Come on, I also. There is a high inrush current. High inrush current depends on. I'm not saying that it depends. It depends on where do you switch on the AC cycle. You need to be extremely careful while switching the capacitor circuits. While energizing the capacitor circuit, and you should be extremely careful while switching off a inductive circuit. So these are the issues. So depending upon the AC cycle, arbitrarily if you close, there will be a huge inrush current. That current has to flow through the diode. Okay. So these are the parameters you need to see. Okay. The short time surge energy that the diode has to withstand, I square T rating, short time, you need to see, depends on the size of the capacitor and the input voltage. This is the parameter. We will cover this in detail, if not today, sometime later. TRR, these are the important, rest all of us know, we don't take this is. What are the type of diodes? Hyperdiode, rectifier diodes, low diodes, non-issues, fast recovery diodes, invariably they are used in high frequency switching, in even PWM, wherever there is a switch frequency is high, I need to go in for fast recovery diodes. Okay. Schottky diodes and new diodes that are coming in are silicon carbide diodes, ultra low power loss, but then they are very expensive. As of now, they are very expensive. Cost may come down. Cost will come down. Okay, silicon carbide. So for inverter and a DC to DC, I have to go in for a very high frequency. I may have to go in for Schottky diode, depending upon that, or fast recovery diodes. I discussed yesterday. Now let me briefly discuss the difference between BJT and MOS. Current control device, the voltage control device, minority carrier device, majority carrier device. Okay, as a secondary breakdown, no secondary breakdown, paralleling is easy, difficult, paralleling is easy, onstate power loss is low. Okay, it is basically a channel, it is formed and therefore the current flows, channel. So when during the flow of current, a flow of water, it only faces the resistance. So I square R, IDS, RDS on, turn off time is higher. Turn off is a very fast device. So an ideal device could be combining MOS and a BJT. Input is a MOS, output is a bipolar junction. So BJT is. Yeah, there is what is known as a cool MOS also. Onset resistance is very low, conduction losses are very low. Okay, cool MOS. IGBT, 1980, invented by again an Indian, Jayantabaliga. Okay, 1983. Okay, insulated gate, bipolar transistor. Prior to advent, yeah. I have to add a BJT at the output. So what do I need to have? One need to have a P stage, which was not there in MOS. Okay, what am I losing by connecting, putting a P stage? P from the drain. Okay, so what will happen when the channel is? How does whatever the holes are? Come on, what is the flow of? What is the principle of operation? We had no P stage in cool MOS. Sorry, in MOS. Now we have a P plus. Okay. The moment I'm putting a P plus, what am I losing? That N stage was not, suppose if there is no P stage, I have only N plus and my P whatever. I am putting in a P stage. What will happen? What can happen? In terms of blocking the voltage. And turn off time. Huh? Yes, becomes indirection. Now it cannot block. Huh? Negative voltage. P junction is powered by us. Holes are injected into N region. Some electrons combine with the holes. Some electrons combine with those. Remaining holes are collected at the source. J1 can now block negative voltage. Initially. In MOS, N, the moment N is negative, what will happen? Which junction can block a negative voltage? Here, J1 can block negative voltage. Come on, I have a diode. If I make P negative, then it is reverse bias. It can block. Now it can block negative voltage. See, I'll just give a small incident that happened when I was in Kanpur. In 1994 or something, yeah, 95. We imported the GTOs. There are two types of GTOs. What are they? Symmetrical and asymmetrical. Anode short. Asymmetrical GTO is also known as anode short. Okay, which cannot block negative voltage. Okay. And one of our resource scholar started connecting to in AC to DC circuit, AC to DC converter. GTOs are just coming in those days in India. It cannot block a negative voltage. Went on blowing the devices. At that time, even we did not know. Literature was not available. Okay. So you should be very careful as to which device to use if the input is AC or when the excitation is DC. You just cannot arbitrarily put a take a GTO or IGBT and connect it in a circuit. No. Should be extremely careful. Anodes, there are symmetrical devices, asymmetrical devices. An ideal device is an SCR. I'm telling you, it's a very ideal device, very rugged. Unfortunately, I cannot turn it off. There is nothing like an SCR, I'm telling you. It has all the characteristics. It requires just a pulse. All these devices are continuous gate drive. So the moment I use a continuous gate drive design is going to be difficult because I have to isolate. See the problem, you need to isolate your control circuit from power circuit. Are you with me? One way to isolate from control and power is to use a small high frequency transformer. Okay? I can use a transformer provided there are only pulses. The moment if I use a continuous gate drive, the transformer may get saturated. So the pulse may not be produced identically in the secondary. So next way to however provide an isolation is to use optocoupler, opto isolation. The moment I use opto isolation, at the secondary stage there is a transistor, I need to have a separate voltage for biasing. biasing. So in suppose in a three phase inverter, I will address those issues. There are three phase inverter, there are three devices on top and three devices are bottom, and all the signals are applied with respect to what is the reference point?
Okay.
Take half bridge. Okay, S1, S4. Switch, this could be a MOS or IGBT or whatever. What is the reference point for S1? Everything is with respect to its source or an emitter. Okay. All this in the lower half, all the reference point for all three devices is the same. In the lower half. Whereas on top, if the reference points are at a different potential. Different potential. So if I use an opto isolation, I need to have a separate supply. Ground is not the same, reference point is not the same. Now, are you able to understand or no? Reference point is not the same. Okay. So I need to have how many power supplies? How many power supplies? Three power supplies here. Again, these are dual power supplies. Because to turn on, it requires a positive, to turn off, it requires a negative. So, dual power supply, three. And a one common power supply of higher current rating. Hello. Reference point is the same for lower. I can afford to use one common power supply of higher current rating. Again, dual power supply. So I need to have a separate power supply. Designing a power supply is going to be another issue there. Gate. So I'm coming by. So SCR is a very ideal device. Unfortunately, it cannot turn off of its own. Now J1 can block the negative voltage. J1 can block the negative voltage. In this structure, why do you require? See, there is N minus and N plus. N minus and N plus. For normal operation, do you require this N minus both the regions? What will happen? What will happen if I remove N plus? Why do I require N plus and N minus both? Both are N, isn't it? Both are N. What may happen? I'll have N minus only. What can? The moment I'm saying N plus, what do you mean by N plus and N? What that plus sign indicates? Highly doped. Okay? What may happen? There is no N plus, N minus only. This junction may block, I said negative voltage. I said it looks like P plus, there is a P and a N. So it can block negative voltage. But then what is the magnitude of voltage it can block? It depends on what? It depends on doping. I have a highly doped junction and a lightly doped junction. Operation may not, come on, per se, operation may not, except for on times, operation may not affect. But then, what is the magnitude of voltage it can block? Does it depend on doping level? Gentlemen, it depends on doping. Now, what will happen? I said, operation wise, it should not affect because I can remove one junction. What will happen? If I highly doped junction, voltage rating will increase or decrease? IRD, it will decrease. Lightly doped junction, it can block a higher voltage. Lightly doped junction, it can block a higher voltage. So now you see, now if I have to use an IGBT in the AC circuit, or if I have to use an IGBT in the DC circuit, do I need to see what all things do I need to consider? See, I'm telling you, you need not have two junctions here. Need not. Sorry, two layers. Not two junction, two layers. I can just have P plus and N minus. So if I have the reverse voltage, reverse blocking voltage rating of this device is low. So it is not a symmetrical device. So all these issues you need to take care. So what is known as a punch through and non-punch through. Some have only n, just n minus layer is a non-punch through IGBT. If both are present, these are known as a punch through. Punch through IGBT and NPT, 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 non-punch through and punch through. When the reverse voltage is applied, J1 should block negative. Due to heavy doping on both sides, this V is low. So punch through IGBT has a negative, low negative voltage blocking capability, a non-symmetrical IGBT. Okay, non-punch IGBT is a symmetrical IGBT. See here, NPT and PT, same. P plus, N minus. What happens? The moment I modified the structure, something must be happening there. What price am I paying? What am I paying? What price am I paying? N minus, huh? Yeah, what happens now? What did I say? When the moment I turn it, some holes and electrons are combined here. Okay. Now for turn off, complete, when the device gets completely turned off, they have to recombine. Recombine. N minus implies less number of electrons. So what will happen to the turn off time? Turn off time increases, 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 increases. So what is important, see the turn off process, what is known as the current tail. We have a, see the problem, IGBT has a MOS at the input and a BJT. So MOS is a very fast structure, it turns off. But then now I have an, this one, this MOS current has come down. But then during this time, what is known as the current tail, current tail. Voltage across the device has increased, a small current continues to flow. Because device completely turns off when all the charges become, a very small current flows, but then voltage across the device has substantially increased. So there is going to be a substantial power loss, so power loss during the current tail period. Okay. So this has to be minority carriers, everything, the channel disappears, MOSFET blocks the quickly, ID drops, minority carriers in N minus layer gradually recombine, ID decreases slowly, ID decreases slowly. What is known as the tail current, it was, okay. This period should be small since, okay, losses are high, punch through IGBT has a smaller tail time, smaller tail time, has N plus layer, almost similar to, so again, so your heat sink design calculation, because losses are taking place substantially during turn off and current tail period, TF. So all these parameters are given by the manufacturer, the data sheets. So while designing the inverter, you have to take care of SOA, safe operating effort and IGBT, same as the MOS. Okay. Yeah, I don't know how many of you have seen the inverters in the 1980s, 1990s and 2000. What could be the major modification, the improvement? I said improve, yeah, size. What how the size has come down? Huh? Yeah, in the sense, initially we had a small transistor. I had to connect so many transistors in parallel. Unfortunately, paralleling was difficult because they have negative temperature coefficient. Then slowly, then started coming one leg of an inverter, one leg of an inverter. There are three terminals, one is plus, okay, this point and this, okay. These are the three terminals, 1, 2, 3, corresponds to 1, 2, 3, okay. Now I need to apply gate signal, gate is applied with respect to its source. So these two are, these two pins for one IGBT, these two for other IGBT, okay, and one common heat sink, one company. I can mount this, Anna. Heat sink. One more. I can mount all three in one common heat sink. See, originally I had the small transistors, the TO3 package. Body was collector, I guess, right? Okay. And collector potential of see in this collector. This is collector. Okay. Potential may be the same here. Barabas, collector potential here. Different. So I need to mount them separately. Are you with me? You can't mount all the transistors in a common heat sink. Thus technology is improved. I could connect all of them in one common heat sink. But then, see here again, I have to apply the signals with respect to source and emitter. Okay. Their potentials are, the potentials of these two points are different, okay, the reference points are different. So I need to have a separate gate drive. Come on, I need to have a separate gate drive with isolation. You follow what I am saying? So I said I need to have three power supplies of one current rating and one power supply of higher current rating, or have six power supplies of same current rating. Now see the improvement further. All the devices, entire bridge. And these are the control pins. Now here I need to apply, I can directly connect controller signals here. I don't need to give the gate. You follow what I am saying? The output of the microcontroller I can directly connect here. Isolation is built in. Now I need to have only one power supply at the control side or low voltage side. I don't require a separate six power supplies, a dual power supplies at the secondary side, at the output of the optocoupler. I can directly connect. See the reduction in the size of the equipment. Compare it with the TO3 package. Compared to TO3 package, expensive. Only thing is, of course, you can't use it in the first go. If one device fails, you have to just discard it at that cost. Current sensing, everything is the intelligent power module. Power module, driver circuit, protection circuit, over temperature protection, over current protection, over voltage protection. I do not know how many of you, no sorry, I am not underestimating you. The issues, how do I see overcurrent protection? How do I provide that overcurrent protection? Suppose I am using a BJT, how do I provide overcurrent protection? How do I protect the, can you tell me the, see the research that has gone through here to make the compact size, to reduce the size. Now, can you tell me how do I provide? Suppose I'm asking you provide a short overcurrent protection for a device. How do you do? What is the overcurrent protection? What is? No, relay will not. By the time relay operates, the device will be gone. You cannot. Relay fuse and all are, they cannot be used. What do you need to do? You need to sense the overcurrent and immediately you have to shut down. Shut down the gate signal. So you have to sense the current. Now how do I sense the current? Now hall current. The moment I use a hall current, see the cost. Yeah, I'll sense the voltage across the device. See, the moment the voltage, the current flowing through the device increases, what will happen? VC will start increasing, the device tries to come out of saturation. Initially you had saturated it, okay. Now nothing has changed, IB has still remained the same. You have not changed the base drive. Because of the fault, current starts increasing, IB is the same, IC starts increasing. So what happens? Device will start comes out of saturation. So the moment, so it goes and enters into active mode, the moment it starts going active mode, voltage across the device increases. So by that time, if you say my relay is going to operate, you can see the smoke coming out. Take it from me. So what you need to do is sense the voltage across the device, immediately shut off. See the complexity in a gate drive circuit. The gate drive circuit, if your gate drive circuit is perfect, I am telling you, your device will not fail. Till date, I do not think you can have a foolproof gate drive circuit that is available. Designing a gate drive circuit is not easy. And if you make a good gate drive circuit, I am telling you, take it from me, 99% your device will not fail. Device will not fail. So this current is built in here, the over current protection is built in here. So that is the reason, one of the ways I am telling you, let us think differently. Let us not think in a routine way, DC-DC, DC-DC and this one. Can we think differently and try to reduce the cost? We should target those areas, I am telling you. Okay. See the size, reduction in size that is possible, made possible by the semiconductor. Capacity, the rating here is 75 amperes, 1200 volts. Each device, see, if this device is again 1000 volts, 75 amperes, one leg. Six devices of 75 ampere, 1200 volts. Quite a bit expensive, yes. I do not know at what price we imported. We imported 2 years ago. It might have come down by now. Cost is not the issue today. Payback period or reliability. And another today, see, we are, I hope we are targeting the rural area. If you are designing an inverter to the rural sector, what should be the concern? Reliability. I do not need to. Please forgive me, I do not need a very sophisticated equipment. It should work in the rural area. Because if it fails, the person may not know what to do with that. There is no infrastructure that is available to repair. Derating may not help, sir, beyond a point. Which is the weakest link in, I do not, all of you know, if I will come to. So an inverter, what is the weakest link? What is the weakest link in a voltage source inverter? I will do it later. What is the weakest link in a voltage source inverter? I hope all, what is the weakest link? Capacitor, electrolytic capacitor. So the people are saying today, can I do away with this capacitor? Can I do? The moment I say remove capacitor, now it has become, I have to change the power circuit configuration itself. Then I have to go back to a current source. There are only two types, I guess, voltage source and a current source. The weakest link is capacitor. Weakest link is capacitor. You may say, okay, I will derate it, devices. Capacitor failure. See, one of our students is working, maybe I will ask him to talk to you for half an hour on how to improve reliability. People are talking about 20 years, because solar, life of solar panel, Chetan may say that 20 years. Your inverter also should last for 20 years. I don't know, does it make sense? It doesn't make sense to me. I don't think I will use a 20 years old technology, will you? I don't know, these are my views. We are in a buyback period, use and throw within 2 years. Isn't it? Once upon a time when I brought a Premier Padmini, it was supposed to last for the entire generation. Now we, in 3 years, we, in a middle class person also changes his refrigerator, once in lifetime purchases, isn't it? Once upon a time, not so long ago, Godrej refrigerator, buy and keep it for at least 25 years, Premier Padmini ambassador, all those, nowhere. So why are we talking about building an inverter for 20 years? Will I use a 20 years old inverter? And who will I, will I use a 1980 made in water? No, it is highly inefficient, noisy, state of the art is available. We are in a buyback period, buyback era. I don't know, these are my views, but then people are still talking about improving the life and it should last for 20 years. People are talking about reducing the capacitor size. Yes, we are making an attempt. I do not know whether it will be successful or not. So if people want it to last for 20 years, I think we need to at least inch towards that direction, try to improve the reliability. Meantime failure. Yeah. Any questions? So my device part I have more or less covered. MOSFET IGBT diodes, how to operate them? These three, if you know, for solar should be okay. And there is one more very popular topology where I can use it, a grid connection, grid connected inverter, a single phase grid connector where I can use an SCR. Okay, if time permits, I will discuss it. SCR based inverter. What is the voltage profile when the device is being turned off? What could be the max? It depends on the see if there will be a stray inductance. Are you with me? When I turn off the device, di by dt is negative. So L di by dt is negative. So voltage across the inductor can change instantaneously. So net voltage across the device is much higher than the DC link voltage. From here it appears as if the maximum voltage rating of the device here is when this is closed, what is the voltage across? That voltage has to come across this. So it appears as if it is the DC link voltage, which is not the case. It depends on your inductance, the stray inductance and I that is to flow. Okay. Yeah. Any other questions? How the DC link is made? We will show you in the inverter. We show the inverter. It's a sandwich type. You have to reduce the inductance of the DC link. Are you with me? You have to reduce. It is not just a conductor, a copper strip. No, no. This is one copper strip. Maybe this is another copper strip. How they are sandwiched to reduce the inductance? We have to reduce the inductance. You have to reduce the inductance. How it is reduced? You can. We'll show you the inverter. We'll show you the practical inverter. How the DC link is. Yeah. Any other question? Feel free, quick.
Instead of optocouplers, what are used?
Where optocouplers?
Means if there are switches to give the gate pulses. If we don't use optocouplers, you have said here the sign is.
No, see, let me correct my statement. I said. One way to provide isolation is transformers, right? And if the there is a fear that transformer may get such a may, I am not saying the transistor will. If continuously if you give, yes. Now you can design a transformer. You can design a transformer. You can design a transformer. See, we say that transformer is a differentiator. Suppose if I give this pulse to this transformer, what do I get here? What do I get here? It's a differentiator, isn't it? Isn't it? Not why? Because it is. We accept that in this zone transformer is saturated. Now you can't design a transformer such that it will not desire. It is possible to design a transformer wherein I get a reasonably good waveform. At the output, it's possible. It's possible. How do I avoid one question that I'm asking? How do I avoid transformer getting saturated? What do I do? I should not allow the transformer to get saturated. Kya kare? Yeah, provide an air gap. Provide an air gap. I should not allow the flux to increase, isn't it? So provide an air gap. Provide an air gap. Now the moment I provide an air gap, yes, that leakage and all will come into picture. Not an issue. Transformer designs for isolating. Transformers are being used in gate drive circuits also. but then it is, these are specially made part transformers, not the ones which are available in the market, pulse transformers.